Greetings to everyone, makers of all things scary. It's me, Sandy, your Haunted Mansion ghost hostess. This video is for making refractory cement skulls for your own fire pit. Enjoy this 7-minute how-to, my scary haunt friends. Peace out.
I thought I would show you some video of how the refractory cement is going. One of these I bought at my local hardware store is almost $28 a bucket. I bought two, so I basically got four full-size skulls. This, it's 11 o'clock in the morning. Here's the other one with no jaw from Nightmare Makers. I bought them a couple of years ago. They don't suggest using their silicone molds with the refractory cement. Nobody's ever used it. It may deteriorate a little bit quicker, but that's okay. I'm just gonna try. I wanna use it in my fire pits. So these are a couple of skulls I got off eBay. And I'm assuming after I get done, after it's done hardening, I'm gonna have to take a Dremel and I probably will lose the molds, but that's okay. Halloween's coming. I wanna sit around the fire and make a lot more of these. All right, peace out. Okay, good morning, haunters. And just like that, it's the next day. 24 hours has passed, so I'm excited, but I'm a little nervous too. So here we go. There's a rubber band on here. These molds are from Nightmare Makers. I bought two of them a couple of years ago. And here we go. Hopefully this peels off. Yep, looks like it's gonna. With some tugging. Ooh. I don't wanna damage anything. Let me pull from the back. There we go. Yay. Oh man, that's awesome. Okay, let's try skull number two. This one is no jaw. Same thing, just no jaw on this one. This one seems a little tougher. Okay. Very cool.
I like it. The details are pretty awesome. Yes, very nice. Wow.
Kidding, I don't have any enemies. All right, we'll make some skulls, you guys. Peace out.